The situation at a dangerous Indonesian volcano has rapidly escalated in the last 24 hours, resulting in a brand new major explosive eruption and now the evacuation of the entire population on the island the volcano lies on. This evacuation involves all 838 residents who live on Ruang Island, but there is a chance that this radius could increase to include sections of other nearby islands as well. Here are the series of events which occurred in the last 24 hours at the Ruang Volcano so you can understand how quickly this stratovolcano went from 0 to 100. Since April 10th, the number of daily volcano tectonic earthquakes began to continuously increase day over day, with a rapid escalation occurring on April 13th. Then, on April 16th at 3 a.m. local time, likely due to the presence of shallow magma igniting sodium in the summit crater, an orange glow became visible to everyone on the island, which originated from Ruang's summit. Magmatic degassing soon greatly increased along with gas emissions, so at 10 a.m. Ruang's alert level was raised from 1 to 2. Gas emissions reached strong levels around noon, and then at 1:37 p.m. an explosion occurred, sending particles of ash to 500 meters above Ruang's summit. What had just occurred was a phreatic eruption, likely caused by residual groundwater in and beneath Ruang's summit crater. Additional phreatic explosions occurred over the following hours, which continued to grow more intense with increasingly tall ash plumes. At 4 p.m, Ruang's alert level was raised once again from 2 to 3, being implemented alongside a 4-kilometer exclusion zone, which placed not only the entirety of the 4.7-kilometer-wide Ruang Island off-limits, but also a section of the nearby Tagulingding Island to the northeast. At 6 p.m, a magmatic eruption began as several initially weak volcanic explosions occurred which ejected bombs of lava. By 9 p.m, intermittent volcanic explosions had become nearly continuous, generating a sustained 1,500-meter-high eruption column above its summit and hurling bombs of lava up to 100 meters from its crater rim. An hour later, an andesite composition lava flow began from Ruang's summit crater towards the east and is now actively heading towards the ocean along the path of its prior 1949 lava flow. Then, at midnight, several pyroclastic flows occurred alongside the occurrence of strong volcanic activity. These seemingly wiped out most vegetation on the island's east, southeast, and parts of the northwest sectors. Lava bombs were thrown 1 kilometer from Ruang's crater, which occurred alongside the generation of a 3-kilometer-high eruption plume. So, is Ruang about to produce an equally powerful eruption as witnessed in 2002? To this I say probably not, as that eruption's explosive list largely was caused by a large lava dome exploding after being emplaced in 1949, and currently there is no such major cap rock on the volcano. Could Ruang produce a tsunami like seen in 1871? To this I say yes, it technically could, although statistics say it most likely won't. However, if you live on any nearby islands and suddenly see an unusually tall ash plume which rises far higher than the others, hear an unusually loud boom, or see the water start to retreat out to the sea, run inland to higher ground as fast as possible. Ruang's 1871 25-meter or 82-foot-high tsunami, which seemingly occurred during only a moderately explosive eruption, was triggered by a flank collapse of 100 million cubic meters of the volcano sliding into the ocean. In my opinion, such a repeat event does not seem likely. However, if Ruang's ongoing eruption proved to be unexpectedly explosive, any pyroclastic flows from it which reached the ocean could technically generate a smaller tsunami through displacement, hence my prior warning. Most eruptions of the Ruang volcano are fairly brief, with its median recent eruption lasting for only 4.5 days, and 75% of its recent eruptions lasting for less than 2 weeks. During the following few days, a lava dome is likely to grow on Ruang's summit, which could block the upward motion of magma if it becomes too large. Volcanian activity, in my opinion, will likely continue to get stronger over the following days, perhaps reaching a volcanic explosivity index of 3 before the eruption ends. If this occurs, light ash will likely fall on nearby islands, and there will be disruptions to air traffic at regional islands.